We have data for employees and we have their names, the city, we have the title over here, the hire date, and the salary. And we are supposed to get in this column F the year hired. There is a function that can extract the year from a date. The hire date is in column E, and the name of the function, as you can imagine, is year. And you can actually hover over, returns the year of a date. So let's double click it. And serial number, remember the dates have numbers behind them. Like the first one would be number one, would be January 1st, 1900. So let's go ahead and click on this and let's see 2007. And let's double click to bring it down. If we're doing this, the border over here will be messed up because 2007 here, the one on top doesn't have a border. So I'm going here and I'm going field without formatting. Let's calculate now the years employed. So we have the hire date, and suppose we want to see by the end of 2021. So we're going to have a year fraction. That's the name of the function. And let's get more help. We have to give you the start date, which is the hire date, and then we have to give you the end date, which is the last day of year 2021. And because this date is in one cell in F2, and when we fill it down, we still want to take F2, we need to lock it. So I'm going to push F4 to get the dollar signs in. The last argument is optional, but let's take a look what it is actually. So when you go help on this function, it explains that if you do not put anything, it's automatically zero. And that means we assume that each month of the year has 30 days. So 30 times 12, you're going to have 360 days in a year. And you might say, okay, that doesn't really work. And then you have some other options you can use. But let's take a look at this 360-day calendar. If you look at this one, is actually used in financial markets, in computer models, and in some other disciplines. And it's actually the average of the lunar and the solar year. So I'm going to put a link to the Wikipedia page. It's quite interesting. So we will leave it with the default, which is 30 days per month. So let's push OK. And now let's bring it down. And as we did before, because I do not want to mess up the border, I'm going to choose fill without formatting. Let's now find out the weekday. So there is a function called weekday, returns a number from 1 to 7, identifying the day of the week. So let's double click it and get more help. The serial number would be the date, so they were hired on that date. And the return type, let's get more help. If you don't put anything, then Sunday is 1. But it looks like we would like to have Monday as 1. So let's open this function. To have Monday, starting from Monday, we need to have 2 for the return type. So let's get back to the function. And under the return type, let's type 2. And bring it down. And let's fill without formatting. We know that for number 4, we would like to show Thursday. So let's go ahead and use the XLOOKUP function, the new function, which is actually very friendly. If we want to get more help, we can click f of x, but let's see if we can figure out using the function arguments. The lookup value is what we are looking for, so we are looking for number 4. I'm going to type in a comma. The lookup array is where we look for number 4. So an array is a list of numbers. So we're going to look in this list of numbers with the day codes. I'm going to type in a comma so we can go to the next argument. The return array would be the weekday. So for number 1, it would be Monday, number 2, Tuesday, and so on. So these are the actual results. And that's it. That's all we need. Now, because I'm going to fill the formula down, H2, H6 will move down, H3, H7, and that's something I do not want. The same thing for I2, I6. So I'm going to select all these guys here, and I'm going to push F4 And that will make them with the dollar signs, which means that we have absolute reference. So the ranges will stay in place, will stay put when we fill the formula down. So let's push enter and let's fill the formula down without the formatting because we do not want to mess up the border. And let's double click and see. Okay, you see how H2H6, I2I6 are still there.